So I'm joined here today for the vote by Mark Berry from the Gun Brewery. Welcome to the vote.
Thank you for
Mark.
Having me.
So it's another brew we've got on the vote, which is always a good thing. So what's unique about Gun Brewery then? And tell us a bit about, firstly, your heritage, I think.
Yeah, well, we started in... the idea for the brewery came about in 2013. I was looking to find a job, and a friend of mine was had a farm. And we decided, rather than get jobs, the actually thing to do was start a business together.
Yes.
Good idea. And it not a bad idea. Employ yourself rather than get someone to employ you. And Toby had a derelict farm, essentially. It was 140 acres. And over the course of 3 or 4 years, he'd rebuilt several houses on the farm and put up a couple of barns. And also, the other thing he'd done is put in a borehole. With a spring water source. So we had a barn with a spring water source going into it, and we knew we wanted to do the business on the farm, so it took about 30 seconds to decide that actually what would be a good idea to look at is possibly brewing beer. So we started taking a look.
And it's based where? So it's called Gun Brewery because it's on...
We're on Gun Hill, yes. Yeah. We're on Gun Hill, which is a road near Chiddingly, is the nearest village, just north of Eastbourne.
Yeah, but you consider yourself a Brighton brewery because that's where a lot of your products go into Brighton, don't they?
Yes. Our principal market is Brighton. We have two vans, and they come here probably 3 or 4 times a week. Yeah. So we put a lot of beer into Brighton.
Yeah.
And we were both Brighton-based before moving out to the countryside. So we consider ourselves sort of Brightonians as much as.
And how big's that? How big's the operation then over there?
So we started off with just the two of us making beer. And that was in, we sold our first pint in January 2015. And since then, we always knew we were going to employ a brewer, so our first hire was a good brewer. And there are now 8 of us. And in terms of volume, we're probably doing 60,000-70,000 pints a month at the moment.
Okay, so that's quite a lot then.
Yeah, it's grown from nothing.
Just to name a few locations, it's the Mucky Duck over the road do some of your products, but where can we find your products?
So I'll say that thing they say about books, all good pubs in Brighton.
Oh, right, yeah.
sell our beer. Yeah. So you've got people like a lot of the Lane pubs sell the beer. Lots of small independents. So if I think about the central Brighton, St James's Tavern sell the beer.
Yeah.
The various Indigo bars sell the beer. Preston Park Tavern.
Yeah.
That way. I mean, numerous. The Walrus, the Lion and Lobster.
Yeah.
If you want our beer in Brighton, you can generally find it.
It
might end badly if you have a pub with all the pubs.
Yeah. So what are your products then? You got some really. I love the names of some of these beers.
Yeah. So we've got a core range of. It's currently 11 beers. A core range of 7 beers. It expands. And at the same time as having a core range, we also do what we call our small batch range. With any brewery, what you tend to find is eventually 1 or 2 beers sell more than others in volume, and those are generally hoppy pale ales.
Yeah.
So our two big sellers are Scaramanga, which is a 3.9% extra pale ale, sort of limey, zesty, sort of tropical fruit flavours, and a 4.6% American pale called Project Babylon.
Yeah.
And so those are the big volume sellers. And we could really brew them all day long, but part of the reason to go into brewing is an expression of creativity.
Yes.
It's like cooking. You don't want to be cooking the same dish every day. It gets boring.
It's a cool occupation, really, isn't it, to be a brewer?
It's good fun. It's a nice market to be in. So you kind of we bought a small test kit. So we have a big kit which produces about 3,000 litres, roughly 6,000 pints at a time. But to give the brewers something to entertain themselves and to keep our ideas fresh and to experiment with, we've also got a smaller kit, which we got. Beachy Head Brewery was a brewery out near Eastbourne, Beachy Head, that closed down. This guy called Roger, he was retiring, and he had a much smaller kit that makes about 800 pints at a time. And so we bought the kit from Roger when he retired, and that is now our test kit. So we, not weekly, probably every 2 weeks, we're now producing another different beer. We've recently, the latest one in the fermenters is a Cali Pale, but we've put strawberry in it. We've done a Dunkelweiss, which is a dark wheat beer. We've done hoppy sours, a huge number of beers in our small batch range. So we have the core range and we have the small batch range.
Okay. Yeah. And where can we find out more information? What's your website?
We're gunbrewery.co.uk, one N, gun.
Great, okay. And we'll leave the story for the logo. Just hold it up, it's your logo. But there's a really good story about that, isn't there? But we'll leave that, I think, for another time. But yeah, people can find out about you on your website. And
yes,
thanks for coming in, Mark, today.
Thank you for having us.
And all the best with Gun Brewery.
Thank you.
We'll catch up soon. Thanks.
Terrific, thank you.